Bloom. More info at fullandbloom.com. In today's Full and Bloom Flashback, we revisit an interview guitarist Vinnie Vincent did back in 2018 at the Atlanta Kiss Expo on leaving Kiss after the Lick It Up touring cycle. The problem was really simple. I was writing a lot of songs, and I felt us growing so much as a band, and I wanted them to want me. I know they wanted Eric Carr, but I didn't feel that they wanted me. Even after Lick It Up, the perception of it was that it was a big album, and I still felt no matter what I do, they're just not gonna want me in this band. And there was a contract they wanted me to sign. My take-home pay was $550 a week, so I never made any money being in the band. From the beginning to the end, it was $550 a week. That's what they paid me. That was my take-home after taxes. This was my dream to be in this band. I didn't want anything as much as I wanted this. Maybe just a little bit so I can buy a house or something. Maybe I could buy a nice car, but that wasn't gonna happen. And the contract they wanted me to sign, it was an employment contract. And there was literally nothing in it for me. I had a family. I had twins that I didn't know I was gonna have. And there was no money to take care of them. And there was no money to buy a home. We were living with relatives and I was on call 24 hours a day, which was okay. It was all okay. But I couldn't move on. There was the future of being Vinnie Vincent of Kiss and what that was. But financially, there was no future in it for me. And I didn't want to be a royalty member, although that would have been nice. But that's not what I asked for. I just asked for something that could take me out of living in an apartment or with my relatives, and maybe a nice car instead of driving around in a car the size of a can of tuna. And while I'm on the road, I've got a family, I've got little children. I wanted to know they were well taken care of, and at least that some of my value, my worth to them would have been special to them and said, look, we can afford to make this work for you. And they just didn't. Just please treat me better than this and everything will be fine. There was nothing. I never saw any royalties during the time I was in the band. It was just a paycheck that I took home 550 bucks a week. So after the Lick It Up tour was a success, I'm thinking, we have a great band, this is a new chapter, this is now. The makeup came off. This was probably for Gene and Paul a really difficult time, because the makeup was what the band was. To remove it, I think, was a bit of a relief. This is my opinion. It was a bit of a relief, but there was also a bit of fear, trepidation, because you didn't know what was coming. But Lick It Up said, even with Benny, this worked. The songs were great, the reception was great, the tours were great, and at the end of the Lick It Up tour, the last thing we said to each other was, we're gonna record a new record. Come back in about 2 months with your new songs. Everybody said, see you then. We're gonna record our new songs, demo them, bring them together, and see what we've got for the new record. I recorded and demoed the future Vinnie Vincent Invasion songs, Boys Are Gonna Rock, Shoot You Full of Love, No Substitute, Animal and Twisted. Those were the five songs that I wrote that I was gonna bring back. They were demoed and I said, this is gonna be one hell of a Kiss record and I think they're gonna love them. So they asked me to come back and I said, I wanna come back, but I've gotta survive. I can't survive on this and I'm coming back with a great album. Can't we make this work? And unfortunately, the answer was no. Unless you sign the contract, you can't come back. And I said, you know what? This is gonna break my heart, but I can't come back. So then about a month later, in May of 84, they sent me a letter saying, well, you're fired. I guess it was redundant because I already said I wasn't coming back if you can't make this work. And that's what happened, and it broke my heart.